I nudged the screen forward, and then the monsters came. Alright, well, let's get rid of these. Thank you, my dear. It's time for that classic. Matt opens a soda on a video.
You're supposed to do that at the beginning.
Then this will definitely be the beginning of one of the videos. Aww. As you were unable to hear my shout of joy, I have not found it yet. Sometimes this is what discovery is.
Boring.
A lot of these have tricks where you reset, because they load into a specific part of memory whenever you start a game up. So a lot of it is get to a spot and save, and then open, and then dash in a direction, because it's going to be there every single time. I think it's the same general idea behind a lot of speedrun tactics. Is knowing how a game is going to load something into memory and then operating off of that, like off of internal timers and things of that nature. I never had a big interest in speedrunning. Definitely not just because I blunder my way through games as opposed to accomplish anything with tremendous skill, but the science behind it is neat. I'm going out of my mind.
Yeah, it's really something over here. Oh, for the love of God. Sorry, I'm trying to do something and it's being stupid.
Okay, because sooner or later this is not going to be fun. I'm going to...
What on earth are you talking about?
Fly south to Nasrad. Keep my eyes open for it.
Okay.
I'm going to sell the discovery that I have. Because the Skull Rock is the one that we need to make sure he doesn't get. I should have sold it while I was there. Yes, I know this thing up there that is above the sky. I cannot get it.
Yeah, that's later.
And then I'm going to come back and we're going to actually do, we're heading to Tuketsu. Hello, everybody. What's happening here? Let's get rid of them. Any minute now, Vi's. Please cast a fire spell and get rid of everything. Yes, this is the sort of thing I was looking to prevent. There we go. Give me strength. Oh, one's blocking. Oh no, I'm alone. I'm also looking for discoveries. Did you find Skull Rock?
Is it over already?
There you go, my little traveling friend. Goodbye. Goodbye, where am I? Help, I'm lost. Is over here. I love that you can then see the discoveries on the map when you're traveling around, even sometimes after you find them, sometimes before, and that's how you find them. I just think that's awesome. I also think it's very funny when you come into a room and it's definitely like, what is this? Boy, oi, 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 it's a hammer. Hello, friend. I have proof that I'm great.
Tell me how awesome I am. I've heard of
its existence. I will pay you if you know its location.
I know where it is.
That's that guy.
Found by us.
Bang, 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 bang. Look at all. Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them all.
We are the greedest.
Look at them all. Look at them all.
All right, so what now?
Read them and weep, dickbag.
That's not very nice.
12, 18, 24, 30. I know how to count. 34. I'm on it. I got this. We're actually going to head up and do the thing, though. What? Sorry, thing? I forgot how to count by sixes. It was real bad.
Which thing are we doing?
The actual, like, dungeon.
The plot? Okay.
Yes. Time for a dungeon run. Like that popular mobile video game. Dungeon run. Meanwhile, Megan is measuring her biceps.
I'm trying to decide how big this tattoo should be.
Thing we often do. 27 inches around here. Oh, yeah. That's not true at all. I have no.
Now I am
definition.
Measuring my biceps. I haven't been doing much arm stuff, so. 10 inches, not bad. My arm at rest is about 9 3/4, so.
It's not bad, he says, having no idea what is and is not bad.
I don't know either. I just know it's like, hey, I flex and it gets bigger. That's good.
Sports science. I do love how nonsensical our videos together can end up being. That's not sarcasm. I really like it.
I had it exactly the right size by eyeballing it.
Nice.
I'm very excited.
I'm so easily off in my own little world when I'm doing my own. I probably should have healed, but I didn't, so we're all going to have to live with that decision. Give me strength. Fire from the belt, apparently. Ah, the scorpion is weak to fire, which we're not using.
Bah. Bah. Bah.
Stab.
That really looked like he was aiming more at Vice's butt.
I feel like I've played this game like 8 or 9 times. I still have no ability to retain what elements are weak against what. I imagine the same thing will happen if I actually attempt to play the new Pokemon when that comes out, because I kind of want to. I've never played a Pokemon game other than a little bit of Pokemon Conquest, which was not very good, but did have Samurai Warriors characters in it, and that was good.
Yeah, I'm.
But those are like, oh, and a little bit of Pokemon Go, but that doesn't have any fighting in it, so you're not doing things like, oh, well, the fire is. Fire type is strong against grass type, which I think is actually one of the ones that is true. I just don't know that stuff, and I'm not going to remember it when I'm playing either. Like, does Fairy beat Ghost? Who knows? Not me!
The problem is there's just so many Pokemon types, and then you have subtypes. Like, this is a flying fighter Pokemon. This
yeah,
is
where
a...
they count as... Like, do their weaknesses count for both, or is it just one? Does the first one have any things? If you know the answers to this, don't tell me. I don't care that much yet. Yeah. Pokemon. That's cool that it's so complicated. Like, that's awesome people that anyway. The reason I wanted to play Pokemon to begin with was I saw the size of one of the strategy guides. I was like, that's like 600 pages. That's great for me. I hate free time.
It's true, he does.
Okay. We're here. I'm healing. I've sorted. It's the lizard door.
You're a lizard door.
Oh boy, co-op doors.
Did you try knocking?
Definitely a cool, calm, and collected airship captain.
Mm-hmm.
These two I buy. Fina is surprised by literally everything that's ever happened. What are the odds? Hips.
Aiko's pretty great.
I love how refreshingly simple she is. All right, what's over here? What's over here? It's treasure. It's a sky wing. That can only be one thing. A cool new boomerang. It always returns, no matter how far it is thrown. I have to go outside and test this out. Let's do an airship and then go as fast as we can.
Go on our balcony, see if you can hit Maryland. Which, considering we're not facing Maryland, that would really be a coup.
It was always a fun thing in World of Warcraft, where you would, speaking of things chasing you from far away, is when you would... what to do here. Just attack there.
Kill it. It's horrifying. That's what you do.
I know. I'm working on it. Something would be trying to chase you while you were on your mount, or like shoot a doom bolt at you or whatever, and that would just follow you all across the world. I loved that. I loved that every time. Oh, it's adorable.
Oh, it's filled with lightning. That's a Pokemon, I'm pretty sure.
That's a Pokemon.
There are quite a few lightning rodents in Pokemon.
Panic!
Who's panicking, us or him?
Him. Because he's silenced! Aha! Wall rank. That could be a Pokemon name. We'll judge all of these by...
their suitability as Pokemon?
Yes. I was going to have the conversation of what's the best starter Pokemon, but we already had that, and everyone else is wrong.
Charmander.
Squirtle.
Charmander.
Squirtle.
Charmander.
Look at fucking Squirtle.
Look at fucking Charmander.
Look how fucking perfect Squirtle is. And he turns into a turtle with giant tank cannons.
Charmander will light you up.
Yeah, I've seen, how many dragons have you seen? You've seen one dragon, you've seen them all.
Not
you've seen
with
one
the
Squirtle.
Tail, his tail,
you're so happy.
Just always like a little candle.
I'm not saying he's not good, because he's good, but he's not Squirtle.
At least we all agree that it's not Bulbasaur.
Bulbasaur's evolutions are distressing to me on, like, a psychological level. Zivelin Bane. Lord Zivelin Bane. It's always a Zivelin Bane song. It's not good, but it happens every time. And we're powerless to resist.
I was saying this last night. It's like, you think there are people who don't, like, sing little songs to themselves while they're doing things?
And as I said at the time, those people are cops.
What was it? Oh, because every time I go, there's a particular city in Final Fantasy XIV called Limsa Lominsa, and it's on the ocean. And so every time I go there, I have to sing Limsa Lominsa, city by the sea, every single time. And Matt has yet to kick me out of the apartment, so... And then I thought last night, do you think there are people who don't do this? Am I weird or are they weird?
They're weird.
Okay.
Take that. I got guns. That seems less like he's blowing the smoke off the edge of it and going, oh, gun, I love you.
Mwah. I mean, he does kiss it in one of them. He kisses back by the handle.
I love you, gun.
Don't kiss your guns. That's just weird.
I mean, if that's what you want to do instead of, like, using them for any of their intended murder purposes.
I don't want to kink shame, but...
Smooch your pistols.
But I kind of do. Maybe don't kiss the gun right after you fired it. That seems like...
That was, like, my least favorite Little Mermaid song, Kiss the Gun. I was like, I don't really know what lesson they're telling the people here.
What is...
I'm sorry. Is Gilder made out of steel?
Tang.
That's not the sound flesh makes.
Maybe he's got more guns under his... See, he does kiss it.
I wish they were all that easy.
What is the best Disney villain song, and why is it Poor Unfortunate Souls? Discuss.
What is the pathway? Did I do this? Oh, no, it's a switch. Yeah, I mean...
Might as well touch it.
I didn't do anything, but... Do it again. And... Fantastic. I love how contrived this is.
I think it's great.
I'm smiling. I think it's great. I'm with you. Ah, they don't know we're here. Back off, Alpha Storm. Maybe you've heard of it. Maybe you also kind of hate it at this point. I think I have some stuff that I might be able to... Oh. Goodness. Fina. Uh-oh. I didn't make it any better. Move. Give me strength. I don't remember what wind is weak to, so I'm just going to throw lightning bolts at things, because that's... That worked. I never cast spells in these games, because MP are a finite resource, and so I just don't, because I don't know. It's just like, I can't do that. What if I were to run out? I think one of the last times I played this, I tried to break myself of that habit and had a way easier time. Mm. Holy cow! Okay, it's weak to ice. I solved it, but ice is a single target spell. But it's
until you use
SP.
It more.
I don't know if there are any ice spells that hit everything. I've played this game a lot. Okay. Let's go this way. Sacrolin crystals!
Yay!
I do think I have some chams. Ooh. Ooh, I have one that's also an immediate evolve. I'm gonna hold on to that. So, Cupel is a very strange weapon in that you feed Cupel things and Cupel will evolve. And there are branching paths that you have no way of knowing what they are in game. But I remember one of those, he just turns into basically a thwomp, and that's a good time. Cupel thwomp. They're going to put this on the Switch. They should put this on the Switch. They should put every game on the Switch. But this needs to come out again. Oh, God. Too many. Send Trollk. Fire. Burn with me. Problem solved. What? Stop dodging. Bye. Sentralk. That could be a Pokemon name, but I don't... doesn't really... It's kind of... I don't... Oh, Sword of the Cat. That's not useful for you at all.
He shouldn't have left it here.
Why did he give it to a bunch of weird snakes? All right, and I did that. All right. Yes, Centrolk is not a very good Pokemon name.
No. But then a lot of Pokemon don't have good Pokemon names. Like Krogunk. Or
no, Krogunk is an amazing Pokemon.
Or Spewpa.
Spewpa.
That's a real thing. I'm not making it up.
Spewpa.
Horrible.
Up in poison, I fell down. I feel a little bit sick, so I've thrown myself onto my back like I'm doing a wrestling bump. See, that I actually believe. Then a snake came and punched me in the chest. That will make me fall down. And now I'm asleep and poisoned. I've got the yuck gut. Incremus. Okay, this is not going great. Okay.
I believe in you.
Let's not die. And let's use Gunslinger. Everything's great. Gunslinger hits everything in a line. It's amazing. That's why I like it so much, because unlike the other ones, it's a basic attack that hits everything in a line. And it does actual damage, unlike Alpha Storm. But I do like Alpha Storm. $2,001 gold. I'm going to guess that's when this game came out.
Hang on, I have Google.
The GameCube version came out in like 03? Maiden's Armor. That's convenient that they were the ones that got it. Fina, you take damage. You took a little bit of damage. Fina, you don't have a lot of anything.
Originally came out in 2000.
Oh.
So maybe they were
In the U.S.?
No, in the U.S. came out in 2003.
What about the non-Legends version? Like the Dreamcast version. Which is the non-Legends version.
Actually, the GameCube version came out in 2001 in Japan.
Okay. So that could be what
we
this
tracked
is.
It. We tracked it down.
I figured out the joke.
They could have also done the thing of, remember when 2001 was just like the coolest number?
Yes. 4 magic droplets. Let me hit this again. Know if that goes anywhere. Oh, that's like where I want to be.
Hey, you did it.
I got the Kot's armor. Nice. Let's go back and switch to them. See if I doesn't really get them anything. So she wants to go up and switch. I can do this. I can figure it out and get all the treasures. And then his is down. Okay. Got it. Puzzle solving.
How bummed out must she be to see treasure chests that have already been opened?
In the Legend of Heroes series, the Legend of like Trails in the Sky, Trails of Cold Steel, etc., there is like dialogue when you check a chest you've already opened, and a lot of them are pithy little jokes, and I really like them. Here, it will tell you what the chest used to hold. I should show that off next time. All Pokemon also just say their own names. And that's weird. I want them to know that. Sleepies.
Oh no, not the sleepies.
Alright, Alpha Storm will get rid of that. Since apparently it is very nimble and hard to hit otherwise. Yeah! Bless you.
Thank you.
Could stand to heal. That's not the button. This is the button. A Vidal seed. Where? Got it. Oh, hit all buttons slowly. Get one. Still a Cupel sword. Go up. I was thinking one of the tattoos that I would want to get would be the actual best Swakodiner badge that someone made for, which was like multiple ones of the... Oh, it's like the Soul Eater rune and the sword shoot, the bright shield and whatever the name of the sword one was, like all together from the first two Swakodin games, because I'm the best Swakodiner.
It's true, you are.
So I'd like to get tattoos for things that like that I really like in some way. And that was just a fantastic game series. I really enjoyed playing them all, and I wish they were to make another one and have it also be good.
Oh, you ask too much.
I do. A Moonberry! Well, it's not for them. Oh. Get away from me, Baru. They look like those, like, animal pillows.
Yeah, kinda, the Pillow Pals.
Thank you for knowing what those were called.
I'm guessing that's what they're called. I don't actually know for certain.
It would make sense. Stop it. Those don't look friendly at all. Weird knife dog. Knife Dog would be an excellent Pokemon name.
You guys, my mom got a dog.
Knife Dog used disembowel. It's super effective.
I don't think she has knives. This dog.
That dog's very cute.
We won! Good dog. We
won! I think that's everything for her. Alright, Vizen Gilda. You're in. Oh, Rizan crystals, also known as the things that never work, so they're terrible. Hang on, the nightmare sound.
There it is. Get the nightmare.
Alright, two chests. Oh, I see another one. Mixer apparently supports 12 microphones.
I need to make some
maybe
friends.
Maybe just six. I'm not sure. It's too many.
It's too many microphones.
I've never known that many people. Not since like high school.
Take that.
Uh-huh. Oh no, the pillow pal.
You bastard. Take that. He sounds like such a dork, I think, is the problem.
Oh, like all in a day's work.
Sounds like a Spike Spiegel cosplayer. Oh boy, another Electrum box! That's definitely something that I want. What? What is this room?
Bad news for you, I think.
Another one of those I can turn. If I go over to this one, what do I find? Not much. Let's go and turn. I'm just gonna guess, though, that if I turn this one more and then go over and hit the switcher, that there'll be a chest that Bias can get. It's an RPG. You do everything except what it wants you to do. Huh. I was incorrect. Weird. Do this though, is he able to do anything? Nope. Alright, so I think Vise has to get there first. I can do this. I can do this.
You can totally do this.
It's alright. So let's take this down. Go over and switch. Whoop, that's not what I meant to do. Or, if he's on this side, can I do it where they both get there at the same time? Let's find out. Yes. The amount of time making this place must have taken. Megan, would you like to tell our friends at home about the cool tomb we were exploring relics from?
You mean yesterday?
Yes.
Yes.
I was waiting for the answer to be no.
Nah, I'm good. So we went to the National Geographic Museum here in lovely Washington, D.C. and saw an exhibit on the Queens of Egypt. Primarily highlighting the tomb of Queen Nefertari, who is kind of a big deal as far as archaeology is concerned, because, as is so often the case, her tomb was one of the best preserved ones that they found. So, when that happens, it's like King Tut. King Tut, in Egyptian terms, was really not a very big deal, but, because his tomb, when they found his tomb, it was so well preserved, he kind of entered the general parlance simply because we were able to tell a lot about him. And it's similar to the case with Queen Nefertari, who I'm always confusing with Nefertiti. They are not the same person. Although I think they were married to the same guy.
Were they? I don't remember.
Well, because Nefertiti was married to Ramses II, and I can't remember if Nefertari was Ramses II or III.
I'm really sorry I asked you that question right before we're about to have a thing happen.
Basically, we saw cool stuff from her tomb. It was neat.
You can talk about it during whatever. Who knows what's going to happen after we open this treasure? I can buy my ship. I capitalized my T.
That was quite a noise she made.
Yay!
That was a thing.
Oh, look at these dorks. I love them.
Oh, don't cry, Vina. Everybody's all misty-eyed except for Gilder.
How about a little sugar for Gilder over here, huh?
I can't help but notice, but that you're not hugging anyone. I just didn't. I hadn't gotten around to it because of treasure. Ladies just hanging off you.
I met them like 3 times.
Ew, you. The creeper! Vice!
The general goes to war with the soldier he's got. I missed you too.
I forgot this part. Hi,
love.
Love. Kiss me.
Tell them more about cool things as I fight giant faces.
Well, so you actually went in the...
Video games are good.
They had like a 3D sort of thing that I didn't go in because I didn't want to barf.
Yeah, I think it would have bothered you some.
I was sort of fighting a headache at the time, and I kind of tell from outside that I didn't want to really engage with it. But no, it was neat. They had So one thing they had that amused Matt to no end is on the wall, as you would proceed through, they would have like, oh, here's this, you know, animated walkthrough of what it would look like in an Egyptian city if you lived there. And Matt just could not get over the fact that it really looked like which Assassin's Creed?
Assassin's Creed Origins.
And he was looking at going, this really looks like,
which is set in Egypt. You're playing as a Magi in
who were like the
Cleopatra era Egypt.
Like
I don't...
secret police. They were the kind of special forces, right?
Yeah. You're essentially an FBI cop, but in a cool way.
And so we're kind of watching this animation, and Matt's like, "This looks like." And then he started to say, "Wait, this legit looks familiar. Like he's seen this before." And I'm like, "And he said, I can see the handholds."
Which is true. I could.
And. So then we were looking at it, and sorry, I'm also trying to do something here. And then he said, like, there was a particular plant on the wall that you were saying looked really familiar, and we're like, did they just, like, does Ubisoft license this stuff? Did they?
Yeah.
And they didn't have anything on the wall describing the animation, just that it existed. And then we get to the end, and there on the credits, the media was partially produced by Ubisoft.
Yeah, special thanks to Ubisoft Montreal as part of that. And that reminded me that as we see the Death Waltz, kiss.
Oh, yeah, it was.
Oh, goodness.
People down.
I need to focus for a moment.
Yeah, you do.
Holy cats. Okay, that was significantly worse than I thought it was going to be. Rizalind Box, Fina, and Sacrum Crystal. Oh, jeez!
Uh-oh.
We're just dead!
Uh-oh.
What are they doing this twice in a row for?
They don't like you.
So...
Wait, I'm not dead!
Yay, Vice!
How many hit points does Vice have?
All the hit points.
No, he has... I mean, look at now, though. He probably has, like, two. I don't think the box broke. Oh, what is this? Why are you exploding? I have good gear. Okay, now Vice is dead.
Vina's back up.
Yes, I did get a revive off. Hi, Fina.
How are you?
Oh, no, it broke. Okay, I do have Rizalind. I can at least get the spell off. But I don't think I'm going to have enough SP to cast it next turn. I remember the trick that you need to not have two of them out that quickly. I didn't think I went in with that low of hit, that low of health. Clearly I did.
They're exploding again.
Well, that's okay. That's not great, but I can deal with that. I am glad I revived Phoenix. She has the spell that actually works. But it's 8 SP, which is a lot. She's gonna die. Oh, no! Oh, can't cast it. Well, let's do this. And you are going to use one of those Sacrilene crystals to keep her up.
This should work.
So, yeah. Dynamic music. But, yes, Assassin's Creed Origins was part of what we had there. It was really neat. That was a neat exhibit. It was all dedicated just to the Queens of Egypt. All right, he's up. Half health. I can survive. I might be able to survive a dance.
They also had a description of the major gods of the pantheon, which included a great story that I'm pretty sure I've heard before about Sekhmet, which I'm going to recount now because it's pretty great. So Sekhmet is the goddess of battle, and she's the one with the body of a woman and the head of a lion, or a lioness rather, and she was ordered at kind of her as one of her duties, she was ordered to go down and like fight off some enemies of mankind to protect them, but she was so bloodthirsty that she just started killing everyone. And so to
relatable
to stop her from doing this, they somebody, one of the other gods, they tricked her into drinking a batch of red beer, which because of the color she thought was blood, and so downed it, and then was intoxicated, and so calmed down and transformed into her other incarnation, Bastet, which is the goddess of domestic harmony. And I think that's incredible. And Bastet, when you see, like, you know, the little Egyptian statue, black cat, that's Bastet. And does anyone who's ever owned a cat, a representation of a cat that can be both the goddess of domestic harmony and of battle makes total sense. Because our cat loves me very much and loves nothing more than to try and eat my hand.
That's true. All right, we're back up. We are back up. Oh my goodness, I can't believe we fought back out of that.
The music still seems kind of concerned.
The music's in normal.
Okay.
We're in normal music. Which is still not great. I am here looking for a glyph of might to put on Vise, because he is going to be how we get out of this.
Let's try this!
And we're just going to be using these. All I need to do is get one of them down. So... I'm sad that I don't know how much health Vise had when he died, or because he died that same turn, because that was a total party kill if he hadn't gotten that Rizalind box out on Fina. And what's nice about Skies of Arcadia is if that happens, it does let you just retry from where you are. I'm just like, no, I'll never give up. Which is good, because games where you die and have to go all the way back to your save point and who knows where that is, and that's the only recourse you have, just seems mean. Even though I played some of those. Oh, goodness! I'm gonna need to toss two of those out this turn. Fortunately, I have some Sacrum Crystals. I'm glad I bought them. I got enough for the big guns, though. I don't mind wasting the turn to make sure we get it. All right, I can't remember if we've seen this yet. It's the best thing in the world.
Ouch. You're like knocking his jaw askew.
Smoke him! That's
yeah,
the
now
song.
The music's happy.
That's my jam. That's hell yeah, rocket bikes. And now I got rid of that stupid dance. I don't think there is a performance of the dance alone that's going to happen to me here. And now we need to switch to... Pretty sure red still does good damage to purple. We'll find out. Yeah, it does. Oh.
Mm-hmm. love the happy music.
I do too.
So I'm over here humming it like an idiot.
It's just good. We watch them on boss fights. That's ball game.
Yay!
I wish they were all that easy.
Okay. Shut up!
That's why no one likes you, Gilder.
What a jerk.
Pyro.
Two seeds, Isil and Magus.
You did well.
This is the most ridiculous treasure chest I've ever seen. Determined faces.
We are determined to get treasure.
Ah!
Now, let's just enjoy the facial expressions here. Is it empty? Are we punked?
Oh.
Huh?
The real treasure was the friends we made along the way. I love that it does that completely, like, honestly and earnestly.
It's not funny, Gilder. I'm already rich. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. Oh, you got some nice gear out of it.
Neither of them are into this.
Yeah, you think we'd have learned by now. Is he Tigger? Sounds like Tigger.
Oh, the angry Ike eyes are great.
I'm kind of with Ike on this one.
We're still poor. We're still poor.
We're still poor.
One shiny nickel.
Do 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 do.
Go towards the light.
This is concerning.
The Monoceros.
Monoceros.
We have killed all of the whales. It was great fun. Yes,
oh, shit.
I'm in the ship. I know. I'm in the ship. I'm commanding the ship.
Yeah, but what fun is that?
Where's the... Yeah.
Okay.
Everything's fine here.
Ever go wrong again.
Everything's fine here. Just save our game. Everything's gonna be great. Mm-hmm. And since we have nothing to worry about down south, next time, let's find that discovery we couldn't find.
Okay. Yeah, nothing else is going on that needs our attention.
Yeah, totally.
It's fine. Bye.
Start to finish for Skies of Arcadia will return tomorrow. Thanks for watching.